The teams, we have seen them. Kayshawn opting for the Poliwrath as the counter user. Lyle opting for the Vigoroth, incredibly neutral into everything except that Poliwrath. They have dueling Lickitungs. And from there, we have the dueling Gligars, and then we have a bit of variety here.
Yeah, there's going to be the difference in the fighting types and the difference in the water types. So Vigoroth and Azumarill for Lyle Jeffs, and on the other side, Poliwrath for the fighter and the water type. kind of doing both roles with one Pokemon.
And as we take a look at Lyle's team, we've seen these movesets. They're very, very standard, but that's what makes them strong. These are battle-tested movesets. These movesets and these six Pokemon have won a regional before, and it's being piloted by a trainer who has top cut many times, been in a grand finals before.
And on the other side, standard is standard. There's a reason these Pokemon run these movesets. These movesets are the best that these Pokemon have to offer. They made the moves themselves, right? That's their moves. They author the moves. Counter, Icy Wind, Scald, very impactful for the Poliwrath. I'd be curious to ask Lyle, maybe sometime after this, the dust settles, how many times he threw Rock Slide for the Vigoroth just because of how impactful Body Slam is. But that's enough. That's enough postulation. We're getting into the games. It's a great lead for Lyle. Gligar into Poliwrath, but Poliwrath can fight back. A tough swap for Kayshawn, switching in Lickitung to be countered by Vigoroth.
Very unfortunate, and it goes to charge attack priority. The Vigoroth able to fire off the Body Slam. Body Slam will do meaningful chip damage onto the Lickitung. Lickitung will look to return fire with Body Slams, but since its fast move is double resisted, it needs to land charge attacks to do any meaningful damage.
And it's meaningful damage, but it's not really ever threatening to knock out. That's the strength of that normal typing, reducing the effectiveness of those licks, meaning that you're always feeling comfortable to get an immense amount of farm with this Vigoroth. I wouldn't be surprised to see Lyle just completely counter down, maybe invest a shield if he's counting right, or if he's counting right, maybe throw a Body Slam at a charge attack time.
My goodness, we see the shield from Kayshawn. Is this going to survive? It does survive the 1 HP of damage through the shield, and this Body Slam will threaten a knockout unless Lyle is willing to commit a shield.
That's such a risky call. If that shield had gone through and the one damage had knocked out, that would have been a completely wasted shield.
Poliwrath looking for the counter down, as Poliwrath with an energy advantage can threaten Gligar with double super effective damage. Kayshawn no shielding the Body Slam, understanding that this is not the charge attack that's going to threaten, instead saving the protect shields for the energy from Gligar.
Gligar throwing the aerial ace as soon as it was get and a catch onto the Frostlass, trying to minimize the effectiveness of this damage, going from super effective to simply neutral. However, in the back is Azumarill. Azumarill's water typing making it quite good against the ice type Frostlass.
Bit of a surprise from Lyle. He has relied on Whiscash so heavily, choosing to bench it in this game number one, but that looks to be the right call as Azumarill is so powerful into this Frostlass, especially with Frostlass having taken the aerial ace. It's now in a range where one player up will very comfortably knock out.
I almost was expecting to see Lyle throw an Ice Beam, because even an Ice Beam would have threatened the Frostlass, even though it's resisted damage. Coming in is the Poliwrath, and the Poliwrath simply has nowhere to go. Azumarill resisting both charge attacks, resisting the fast attack, and Gligar having a good amount of health left. It's too much for this singular Poliwrath to overcome.
The Azumarill is going to fire off the Ice Beam bait. Even if this is no shielded, this can set up a Gligar farm down. This grabs the final shield. Switch clock almost up for Lyle. He would love to get the Gligar in. Switch clock comes up, in comes the Gligar, and the Gligar does have enough of an energy lead that it will make it to the aerial ace before the double Icy Winds are reached. And despite the best attempts of Kayshawn to make it to the back-to-back charge attacks, Lyle secures game one.
And in that interview, Kayshawn focused in on alignment, and he just wasn't able to get it there in game number one. We'll have to see what kind of arrangements, what kind of changes he'll make to his team to try to maybe avoid matchups that are one directional, maybe play some more neutral matchups. It's tough though. His most neutral Pokemon on his team, Lickitung, has a hard answer on Lyle Jeff's team, and it's preventing him to find those positions where neutral play is king.
Lickitung, I 100% agree with what you said. If you take a look across at the Whiscash, the Azumarill, there's so many neutral matchups for it, but it could not find it. It was stuck against the Vigoroth, the shield, able to survive the one HP of damage through the shield and grab the shield back from Lyle. But unfortunately, Lyle is more than happy to shield. He gets the catch onto the Frostlass, but that just puts it in range for one charge attack from the Azumarill.
Yeah, Azumarill's bubble really doing a decent amount of damage against that Frostlass, and Poliwrath's energy is just not quite effective enough into that Azumarill. I thought maybe if a shield came up and he got a counter down, it would have been possible, but the switch clock coming up in time to prevent that from happening. We are ready to go into game number two, finding a more neutral lead. Kayshawn's Gligar into Lyle Jeff's Lickitung.
Typically, you would prefer to be the Lickitung in this matchup. Lickitung able to provide some very consistent damage with the Lick and being able to spam out those body slams. The Dig fired off by the Gligar, immediate no shield by Lyle. He's comfortable taking that damage as he's under no threat of getting farmed down.
First body slam coming through from the Lickitung. Body slam going to get a good amount of neutral damage onto this Gligar, put it into the yellow, and if Kayshawn is going for another dig, it's going to get outpaced, and Lyle Jeff's a master of this matchup, knowing exactly when to throw that charge attack.
Kayshawn can look now to overfarm quite a bit with the Gligar as the Lickitung is nowhere near a charge attack. He's going to look to farm to the back-to-back Aerie Laces, and for Lyle, shielding here does not make a lot of sense because he would have the double shield for switch, so he's just going to take his shield advantage and go for a more neutral play by sending in the Azumarill.
The tough thing for Kayshawn here is that the Skarmory is potentially going to get lined up against the Charger Bug if Kayshawn follows up Lyle Jeff's eventual swap with a swap of his own. So he needs to be very careful here. He is also down shields, so it's going to be really tough for him to maneuver around these final two matchups.
This play rough will be no shielded. This means that the Charger Bug for Lyle will be so deadly in the end game. The play rough is going to connect. We see the switch into his own Charger Bug, and this is very, very difficult to deal with that Skarmory in the back.
Great patience from Kayshawn there, recognizing if I switch, I lose this game. I need to stay in this matchup with my own Charger Bug, and getting the second X-Scissor off is going to be good for him, but Lyle Jeff's recognizing I can over farm here. I'm not threatened. I still have my shields. I'm gonna farm up extra energy to get to two X-Scissors, make sure this X-Scissor lands on the appropriate target by waiting one turn there.
Very nice patience by Lyle. We see the no shield by Kayshawn. That will pick up the knockout. And all that's left in the back is the Skarmory. The Skarmory still has a protect shield remaining, but the energy lead from the Charger Bug just looks insurmountable.
Up to two discharges now, and Kayshawn recognizing it, no shielding the first thing. I know one is going to land, so be it. I will take that damage. I will go for the sky attack here, but I know you have a shield. You can just shield this and likely go for a farm down. Steelwing, not that strong of a move, resisted by that electric typing, not that great in this matchup.
At the back-to-back X-Scissors, Kayshawn with the Protect Shield, but it will not help in this matchup, choosing to let that go, and Lyle Jeffs with the line calls again and again, giving up switch advantage, but still able to have his Charger Bug in such a favorable position in the endgame. Lyle, he's gotten close before. He's now one win away from accomplishing that dream of becoming a regional champion.
And it was a great read by Lyle to bring in that Charger Bug. The Gligar was out of the way, and that is going to be Kayshawn's best answer to that Charger Bug. Here we go back into the game. It is going to be that shielded sky attack going for the X-Scissor here, recognizing this is going to provide that knockout blow to secure the victory.
And if you're Kayshawn, You've played 5 games versus Lyle. Lyle has emerged victorious in every one. You need back-to-back-to-back wins to pull this off. This is going to be a very, very difficult road ahead. But Kayshawn, he's shown grit. He fought back in losers' finals to get to this point. So if anyone can do it, it's Kayshawn.
We've seen it before. People have reversed sweeped grand finals and done and enforced the bracket reset. So it can definitely happen again. Our two trainers are thinking about what sort of changes they need to make here. So much is on the line. This is a win and win situation, not a win and in situation, but a win and win situation. Lyle Jeffs has the opportunity to claim the championship for himself. We are locked into a decisive game number 3 here. It is going to be Frostlass into Azumarill, a great lead for Lyle Jeffs.
Kayshawn choosing to stay in this matchup to start with. One player from the Azumarill will not threaten the knockout, but the bubbles continue to add up onto the Frostlass, firing off the Shadow Ball. Lyle very comfortable with taking this damage onto the Azumarill. Azumarill withstands that charge attack and is going to continue to farm.
This matchup used to be a little bit more favorable for the Frostlass, but since the change to bubble damage, I just sense that Azumarill is so much more comfortable in this matchup. You take a Shadow Ball quite easily. The second Shadow Ball, I don't think, is going to threaten a knockout, and you're able to potentially go for an Ice Beam here and not really be worried about the farm down. Instead, we see Lyle opting to shield this Shadow Ball, saying, I want to make sure my Azumarill leaves this matchup healthy. You don't have that many great answers for my Azumarill's energy.
We see the Ice Beam. It will be no shielded, conceding switch advantage, taking the shields, but switch advantage looks to be very important. In comes the Charger Bug. We see the pivot into the Lickitung. Lyle giving up the switch advantage. Kayshawn firing off the X Scissor.
This is Kayshawn's chance to fight back here. He needs to recognize that there's a Vigoroth in the back for Lyle Jeffs. He needs to switch in his Lickitung, but he's not switching it, isn't in. He's staying in this matchup, trying to get more chip damage with his Charger Bug.
And this body slam will add up. The no shield by the Charger Bug. Charger Bug now below half HP, continuing to farm, saving that Lickitung in the back, making it to the X Scissor. This will not knock out. We see a very confident no shield by Lyle. His Lickitung will withstand the damage.
And Kayshawn, talking so much about alignment, is unfortunately not predicting the Vigoroth in the back for Lyle Jeffs here. He thinks it must be something else. He thinks his Lickitung must be safe against that third Pokemon that Lyle Jeffs brought. In comes a switch now, unable to catch that charge attack onto the Lickitung. Lyle Jeffs on his last few HP for his own Lickitung, and we'll see if Kayshawn decides to throw a charge attack here or not.
Kayshawn can't get the farm down, goes for the Lickitung in the back. It's Vigoroth, and Lyle seems inevitable in this moment. The Lickitung can fire as many body slams as it wants, but it cannot stop the unstoppable Vigoroth.
It's a bit of an interesting situation. The previous game, Kayshawn needed to not switch when Lyle Jeffs switched out of an intermediate matchup. In this game, he absolutely needed to. Vigoroth coming into one of its most dominant matchups in the entire Open Great League format, throwing body slam after body slam, super effective counters, taking double resisted licks. It's so good against Lickitung.
And Vigoroth at so many charge attacks here. This is going to pick up the knockout onto the Lickitung. There is so much energy on the Charger Bug. Lyle Jeffs gets the body slam and he's done it. Lyle Jeffs with the 3-0 victory is your regional champion here in Charlotte, North Carolina.
And with a fist pump, he stands up excited, ecstatic about the victory and a great sportsmanship shown by both trainers there. Really hard fought.